Can you literally create a fuller lip or the illusion of a fuller lip?
It's the illusion of a fuller lip, but with lip plumping glosses and treatments, it does slightly swell your lips as well. So it's kind of a mixed match of both, I think. But the other thing is, I just feel that it's a real trend at the moment, the lips thing. You know, it used to be eyebrows and now it's kind of more concentrating on lips. So it's also about the care of your lips as well. Like, we all know about face masks and things like that. But there are also things...
Sorry, there's a very horrible lazy blue bottle flying around us. Try not to get it on Glee.
But there's also things, lip masks, for instance. These are really, really good. As you can see here, we've got...
Been trying not to make Glee laugh.
I know, bless her. But these are really, really good prep masks. This is from Starskin, and they actually are plumping and hydrating. So, for instance, you can pop this on before you're going to do the rest of your makeup, take that off.
Right.
And then...
So take it out of that packet, and it just looks like that.
You get two in a pack, which is fantastic. And then you simply just... ever so gently, just take it off, and it's got that amazing hydration to the lips.
What does it feel like, Glee? Is it kind of tingly? Was it tingly when it was on?
Cool, and,
nice?
It's a really... Yeah. Do you know what? I burnt my lips on holiday, and I wore those, and it really helped nourish the kind of lip area, which I think is great. The other thing you can do is scrubs. A lot of people kind of do it before they put lipstick on, but actually this one, again, this is from Starskin. This is an exfoliating... foaming lip scrub. Okay. So look, you pop it on your hand here, and then I'm just going to do a little bit of water, and you see it's kind of like a cleanser. Can you see that?
Yeah.
So it actually foams, which is really nice. And what I tend to do is I tend to do this more at night time. So, you know, exfoliate your kind of lips, and then you can do the night cream. So you pop this on your lips, and this is a night treatment, which I think is a really nice thing to do, because a lot of the time you do it all before and then you put lipsticks on, your lips haven't had time to kind of rest.
I've always got slightly chapped lips, and I put so much lip balm on, and I put, you know, petroleum jelly on at night,
I'm
and then
exactly
someone said,
the same.
Oh, you're putting too much on.
Yeah.
But you know, is that right? Can you put too much moisturizer?
I personally prefer to do all of that at night time, a bit like a face mask. I think that's the most important thing. This is the other thing that I'm going to show you. This is gorgeous, she says once doing it. I'm sorry, I've got soapy hands. This is from Soap and Glory. Mm. I love this. So this is actually a lip plumping gloss, okay? So let me show you this.
But how
on.
Does it plump? It's just a lip gloss.
So basically, it's got kind of like a plumping serum in it. So what it does is it slightly tingles your lips. So it makes your lips swell a little bit by basically bringing all the blood to the surface. So it gives the illusion. So your lips instantly go, something's
like
not right
menthol
here.
Menthol or something.
Yeah, a lot of the time it's menthol. But I mean, this is a really nice
pretty
thing
colour.
To do if you're a bit scared of all the kind of, you know, there are quite extreme kind of plumpers.
Can
this
you feel
is actually
the tingle,
just a really nice just kind of do that with your lips. And that's just a lovely one for every day, and it does give a little bit of a swollen lip.
Does it feel a bit tingly?
Yeah.
Because I've had those plumping ones, and they just feel like they've got menthol in them to make your lips tingle.
Some
a bit,
of them are
they?
Quite extreme. Let me go over to Selena. So, right, so
Hi,
we've
Selena.
Got... Hi, Selena. Selena, I've actually applied this one. This is from Project Lip. Okay, so this is a primer, kind of like it's a texture of a lip balm. You apply it to the lips, it's matte, and you kind of moisten it together, and it definitely does have a tingling sensation, doesn't it? It's a lot more heavier than other ones I've tried.
So it's a primer.
So it's a primer for your lips. So then you apply your lipsticks on top. So what this does is this.
So have you got that on now?
Yes.
Yeah.
And what does it feel like?
Very tingly, but not too much.
But you've got lovely full lips anyway.
Oh, thank you.
She has. She's got gorgeous. We actually did it on Amber, and she was like, "It's burning." And she took it before and after, and it looks great. Because I was like, some people are different, react to it differently. But the other thing is how to line your lips. Now, a lot of people know how to line their lips with red lipstick, for instance, because it's a bold colour. You can kind of get away with going really over the top. When it's more of a nude, which is what we're going to do, it's all about contouring the lips. Okay. So even if you have slightly fuller lips, which Selena does, and you actually say, she's like, I love lip liner. I'm going to go in with MAC Spice. This is a classic.
My favourite.
Your favourite. I did that on
time.
Purpose.
Yeah.
So this is a really good nude lip liner. Again, it changes for different people. And what you want to do is go on the outer surface of the lip line, okay? So your natural lip line, you want to go slightly outside it. Mm-hmm. So you're not kind of... So you're giving that emphasis of a slightly bigger lip, but you're not going to the extreme. Now, gone are the days, guys, where you take a brown lip liner or a black lip liner and you do this.
Yeah, there are now... Now you blend it, don't you? So you almost don't look like you've got lip liner
on. You do, but the key to this is
a lot of people with a Cupid's bow, OK? So I've got a really pronounced Cupid's bow. The other really good thing to do is kind of slightly go over your Cupid's bow and fill that in a little bit.
Oh, so that gives you the pouty
look. Yeah, exactly. So it just gives you that illusion. But the other thing to do is everyone always says, like, oh, fill in the lip completely with a lip liner. You don't actually have to do that because you want to give that contour and that slightly puckered shape. What you do is you go on the outside and you fill in that all the way, OK? So you're kind of really giving that... It's exactly that. You're contouring, just like you would with your eye in a socket.
Yeah.
You're doing exactly the same with the lips. But the other thing is, don't go to the extreme of really, really dark lip liners. You want it to be a subtle lip liner, but
well,
also when it comes off, it shows
colour,
nicely.
That spice colour, because you can be quite light or you can make it darker if you want to.
Well, that's the thing. That's what I love about it. It works really nicely. It's a really good nude. The
other can I just ask?
Yeah.
Sorry. No. So when Celine, when you've done that, should you then do the... Or not.
You can do at the moment, because I've kind of contoured her lips. I don't really want her to do that because I'm going to let the lipstick now do its other job. So I've gone for the Avon nude lipsticks. These are fantastic. Basically, Avon have brought out a brand new range where it's your perfect nude for any skin tone, which is brilliant.
So how many nudes have they got?
They've got about five. Yeah, really impressed with this one. This one's a little bit more pinky. And I'm going to go into the middle. And as you can see, this is like a perfect nude for your lip shape, like, and your lip colour. That's the other thing, finding the best nude. But as you can see, it feathers in beautifully, but you haven't got any harsh lines at all. So
I see what you mean about the Cupid's bow, you know, whether you've got one or not, but if you have got a pronounced one, if you fill it in,
it just makes them look a little bit bigger. And I think that's the key, but not to go to the extreme, like, you know, everyone knows that Kylie Jenner used to do that.
And the other thing that's really important is a lip gloss, but go for a massive brightening one. This one's from Bobbi Brown. This is high shimmer.
Why go for a massive brightening?
Because this makes your lips look so intense.
Okay.
And go on the outside. Everyone always thinks popping it in the middle.
Yeah.
Now, what the trend is, and what I've picked up from these amazing makeup artists that you see all over the place, is go on the outside, and this just gives your lips such an extreme shine that you literally cannot stop looking at someone's lips, and that's the kind of whole point, is making them a real statement.
Give us a pout then, Selena.
Very
nice, very nice. Yeah,
gorgeous.
Interesting. You're right over there, you're still tingling.
It's tingly, yeah.
Still tingling, still tingling. Thank you, Bryony. Any of the products there and Bryony's tips and tricks, she will be at This Morning Live with us.
I am,
which
I'm
is
really
very exciting,
excited.
Isn't it? We're all going to be there, the whole family, and we'd love to see you. This is how you can join us.
This Morning is going on the road from May the 16th to 19th with a live event at Birmingham NEC.
We come into your home every day for a couple of hours, so welcome to ours.
You can see all the familiar faces from the programme, like me and Eamonn, Phil and Holly, Rylan, the Speakmans, many more.
All the family meeting all the viewers.
It's a fantastic day out. Lots of food, fashion, beauty, health, homes and gardens to explore.
For more information, go to the website or visit our app and click on This Morning Live, TM Live.